The other type of bias that we have to be careful about is called we call it the approach bias. And this bias often shows itself in the beginning of a project or the way we approach something.
Yeah, we see this all the time when we've run UXD workshops at I/O and a variety of other venues before. And almost 9 times out of 10, every developer, when asked to build a pizza ordering application, thinks about a photorealistic pizza ordering widget that uses some really nifty graphics APIs that they want to go and build right now.
Gosh, Nazel, I'm getting hungry. But why do you think developers approach it this way?
Well, developers love to code. And when asked to design a pizza ordering application, the first thing they think about is what graphics APIs are available on Android and what other pinch to zoom and 3D photorealistic things they can implement right now. And they want to get to it right now. And honestly, as a developer, even when I'm designing things, in the back of my head, I'm always thinking, can I build this thing? How would you approach it?
As a designer, the way I would approach it is this. I would try to imagine a user who's sitting there using their phone and they're hungry for pizza. And they pull up an application and they want to go from being hungry to being satisfied. And I think about, what is the flow I could create in an application that would let them go from being hungry to satisfied as quickly as possible with as little friction as possible and make them happy? So that's kind of like the pure designer approach. But the way that we really want to go about this is not exactly the developer approach or the designer approach. We want to do something that's kind of meets it in the middle. So as a development-minded designer, I think what you would want to do is design something really great, empathize with your user, but keep constraints in mind and keep the question of whether you can really build this in mind.
No, exactly. And another thing is you and I are very familiar with software. Yeah. And the way we think about interaction design patterns and libraries are not the same as a user.
Exactly.
Like when we're building things, we have a certain bias because we're so familiar with these toolkits and platforms that we end up having assumptions about how somebody will actually use a particular widget or control.
Yep.
And that's not exactly how a real user might do it.
Now that we've discussed approach bias, think about the most recent project that you worked on. Think about what you did on day one or how you first approached this project. Did any of your approaches actually bias the final product?